Are you tired of managing IP addresses for your Azure resources? Now, Azure Public IP Prefix enables you to use one prefix to manage all your public endpoints with predictable, contiguous public IP addresses that don't change as you scale. Anavi Nahar is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Anavi, and we're going to learn about public IP prefix. So public IP prefix, tell me what this is about.
Okay, so all a public IP prefix is a reserved range. So think about how today in Azure, let's say you have VM scale sets or application gateways deployed or load balancers. Each time you deploy this and you want it to be public facing, you have a public IP address.
Correct.
Think about how annoying it is to have these individual IPs that you don't control and then carry forward with a list. Oh, this one is for my load balancer, or this one is for my app gateway. So what a prefix does is gives you a range. So when you deploy these resources, you don't have to worry about what IP will be assigned to these resources because it'll come out of this range, which is a contiguous block of
gotcha.
IPs.
Yeah, because I deal with this personally because I run a site out of app service.
Okay.
And I depend on a third-party API, and the way that they give you permission is through your IP address. And I had to go off and scavenge and find and they're not contiguous, right? There's these random IP addresses that
yep.
my app service might speak out from that they then had to put in their database to grant me access. And what you're saying now is that that'll be much easier if I were to use a prefix, because I would just say instead of these five random IPs, just go ahead and whitelist this range.
Exactly. You can just get a /28, for example, which is 16 public IP addresses.
Gotcha.
And so what's funny, Donovan, is the fact that you are the customer that we are trying to solve.
And I am looking forward to this because it's been a pain for me to have to deal with that. And sometimes they'll change, or if you have to reprovision or move it, it's just a nightmare. So no, this will be fantastic.
Awesome.
So how do I actually set it up?
Okay, let's go into the details. So first off, I just have a regular ARM template here. As you can see, I have all the details put in, but I'll spare everyone the details. The main important point here is where I have this prefix defined.
Okay.
So what I went ahead and did in the portal, I created a public IP prefix. It's the resource just like any other resource.
Okay.
You know how you deploy a VM, you just search for public IP prefix, and it'll show up exactly the same as any other Azure resource. So what I did was I went ahead and deployed the prefix, and now I've assigned the ID here in my ARM template. So let's look at that resource really quickly.
Now, I noticed that you're assigning a pre-existing IP prefix, but I could also have deployed the IP prefix as part of that ARM template and just made it a dependence, like everything that needs to depend on that, and then automatically assign that.
Exactly, right, using cool. the depends on function.
Perfect. All right,
yeah,
good.
So that's totally fine. I think it's just depends on the person's style.
Sure.
Usually in automation, that's exactly what customers do.
Okay.
So as you can see, I have a public IP prefix. I'm very creative with the names. I called it public IP prefix 1. It's deployed in West Europe. It's a /28, which is 16 IP addresses. And as you can see, 10 of the 16 were deployed.
Okay.
The next thing I did is I went ahead and just deployed the template that I created that I showed you.
Mm-hmm.
I deployed it in this specific resource with the template file that was in my OneDrive folder, and I called it again very creatively VMSS with public IP prefix.
Got it.
All right, so now that I showed you the prefix and how I deployed it, let's go ahead and see, did these IPs from this prefix actually go into my VM scale set? So when I go ahead and click on my scale set, I see that I selected 10 instances, so I have 10 different individual instances. So let's go ahead and look at them. Here you'll see all my instances are deployed, 0 through 9, of course. I'll click on an individual instance and navigate to the networking blade of that specific instance. Once I do that, you'll see that the IP address that I'm using for it here, the public IP address, is 51.105.233.128.
Gotcha.
Now that probably sounds familiar to me and not everyone else, and that's probably because it's exactly from this prefix here, which we had allocated the 10 IP addresses, which is 55.105.233.128/28.
Gotcha.
Another cool aspect is it'll show you how many IP addresses are allocated. Of course, we made it pretty for the UI here, but you can also do that through API, which is actually useful because let's say your website, you now expand it, or app service, right? You mentioned expands. And so they don't have to worry about the prefix running out because they know, or at least they can set alerts when they're running out and prepare for it for their customers.
Very cool. And this isn't in private preview or anything. This is actually a ready-to-go GA feature that people can start using?
Exactly. We GA'd in March. We previewed it in Ignite before that. But yeah, okay. It's GA in all public regions, even national clouds. So if you want to deploy a prefix in China, you can, even in the government clouds as well.
Perfect. And are there any resources that use IP addresses that this does not apply to?
That's a great question. So public IP prefix today, the IP addresses that you get are standard public IPs.
Okay.
So that means it would be supported for a standard load balancer, the application gateway V2 SKU, which uses standard public IPs. So any resource that can use standard public IPs. In Azure, we have basic public IPs and standard public IPs.
Okay.
Standard public IPs provide zone resiliency, so availability zones. And in case a zone goes down, your application or deployment in Azure won't go down.
Right. And your IP addresses will still be the same across those zones as well, right?
Exactly. And so we support prefix for standard public IPs. So like I said, any resource that uses standard public IPs should be able to leverage this.
Gotcha. And all it is a... So we showed how to do it in the ARM template, which is the way I'm a DevOps guy. It's clearly the way I want our customers to do it. But
yeah.
A lot of our customers aren't there yet, and they still have people that manually go into the portal. Is there a way to assign that prefix to a resource from the portal as well?
So from the from the portal, what you can do with the prefix is create a prefix and then add an IP address, as you can see over here. And once you add an IP address, then it's treated just like any other IP address, and you can select it.
There
are a few features, and we're rolling out the rest of them. We're rolling out the rest of the products that will support it. But in the meantime, you can just add an IP address and use it like you regularly would.
Perfect. We are learning all about public IP prefix here on Azure Friday. We'll be right back.